Thank you for invitation. And I'm very happy to be here at the so beautiful place and present our work here in this conference. the title is Upper Semi-Continuity of Entropy Map for Nonuniformly Hyperbolic Systems. This is a joint work with Gang Liao and Shi Rou Wang. Let's consider the topological system, meaning the continuous map on a compact manifold, compact metric space, and consider all the F invariant probability measures, which is not empty. The entropy map is this map. Give a measure, a point is a measure theoretical entropy. So this is a map. And as we already know, measure theoretical entropy, measure dynamical complexity. And it is an environment for isomorphic to probability systems. And this entropy map is not continuous in general. For example, let's consider the hyperbolic toroidal automorphism. In this example, we take an ergodic measure with positive entropy. For example, the entropy is A larger than zero. Then this measure is approximated by periodic orbit atomic measures. This is a known result, for example, from Sigmund. So clearly, the periodic measure has no entropy. And this measure has positive entropy. So the picture is like this. Here is the measure with positive entropy, and these measures periodic measures. And in this measure, we have a positive entropy, and these measures, the entropy is zero. So this, from this picture, you see easily the this map is not continuous, of course. It's not a lower semi-continuous. So if we say continuous for entropy map, we mean upper semi-continuous. We already know the following facts. Expansive homomorphism of compact metric space. For this space, for this topological systems, we have the upper semi-continuous. And for expansive map, we have this property. And also for asymptotic entropy expansive map, we have this property. And also for C1 diffuse far from tangency, we have this map. We have this property. And also for C infinite map, we have this property. Now we consider the property for non-uniform hyperbolic system. The definition of non-uniform hyperbolicity, we take this definition. Well, M is a compact Riemannian manifold, and we consider one C1 diffeo on the manifold. And then we take three numbers, lambda S, lambda U, and epsilon. Epsilon is quite smaller than these two quantities. And then for each K, we define lambda K. This one depends on these three parameters. To be all the point X for which the following truth, there is a splitting with the invariant property. This is the invariant property. And satisfies the following. The first one, if we consider the restriction to ES bundle, then this normal is less than this quantity. And if we consider the restriction to the EU bundle, then this inequality holds. And also the angle between the two bundles decreasing not not very fast, not very fast. Then we consider the union of lambda k, and call this set passing set. And in this case, we call lambda k passing block. The picture is like this. Here we have one block, and here we have another block, lambda 2, and so on, and so on. In each block, the splitting is continuous, and it is uniformly hyperbolic. But each block is not invariant in general. If we consider the union, it is an invariant set, but it's not compact in general. Now we consider all the measures, invariant measures apart on the passing set. That means, sorry. A measure belongs to this set if and only if lambda has measure 1. Any invariant measure with no zero Lyapunov exponents is called a hyperbolic measure. For an ergodic hyperbolic measure, we could define a passing set associated to it in the following way. Let omega be the oscillating basin of nu, where all Lyapunov exponents exist by oscillating theorem. And this one has a nu measure 1. Denote ES and EU the direct sum of the oscillating splitting with respect to negative and positive Lyapunov exponents respectively. And let lambda S be the norm of the largest Lyapunov exponents of vector field vectors in ES, and lambda mu the smallest one in EU, and consider epsilon much less than this. So this means for ergodic measure, the Lyapunov exponents are constants. These are positive Lyapunov exponents, and these are negative Lyapunov exponents. So we consider this gap. And in this case, omega is contained in the Python set we defined previously. Now we denote epsilon bar, which is a decreasing sequence of real positive real numbers, which approach zero, and denote this subset. This is the subset of this this set of measures with this property. With this property, this means what? This means measure could not have a very large side with large measure in the in lambda k, where k is very very large, very very big. we call this epsilon bar hyperbolic rate. And Newhouse proved the following. He proved that the entropy map, if we restrict to this subset, then it is upper semi-continuous. Roughly saying, for C plus 1 plus alpha non-uniformly hyperbolic diffuse, the entropy map, when restricted on the set of hyperbolic measures with the same hyperbolic rate, that means the epsilon bar, then in this case is upper semi-continuous. Question: is the entropy map upper semi-continuous when restricted to hyperbolic measures without the same hyperbolic rate? Okay. Yeah. Yes. This is the measure supported. This is lambda. Lambda. Yes. Yes. That means the measure should concentrate it in the large part in the passing block in smaller number. Not very bad. This set of measure has some have the same hyperbolic rate.
That's what we call hyperbolic rate, epsilon sequence.
Yes, yes.
What do you mean by weakly decreasing?
Is
so this epsilon k has some rate of
increase
or
decrease? Yeah, you put any epsilon bar. Yes, yes.
And how do you know that the set of measures is not empty? For some epsilon,
it
will be empty. Or not?
This measure is not subset is not empty in general. For example, if you.
So
Yeah.
Just one thing. I mean, of course, all the measures support Yeah, this one, you can choose one epsilon bar and consider this set. And you can choose very freely to choose epsilon bar. This is not an empty subset in general. Okay, so if we do not have this assumption of same hyperbolic rate, the answer is no. This is the upper semi-continuity is not true for C1 plus alpha, non-uniform hyperbolicity. Let's analyze one example from the Norwich and the Newhouse. Take an open subset and in the CR diffuse. And such that F in it has a hyperbolic basic set with the same adopted neighborhood U, which has persistent homoclinic tangency. Persistent means we make any small neighborhood, we find such map. And then take a hyperbolic periodic orbit with this one. This means the roughly say it is the Lyapunov exponent of the point P. And then we may assume that P is both R shrinking, meaning this property, and now resonate, meaning this property. From this, by a CR small perturbation, there is an interval I of the tangency between WU and WS. Near this interval, we make one more small perturbation, which we denoted by G to create a curve in this W part with N bumps as in the following picture. In this picture, the interval from AI to A2 is denoted by I. And the J is this cosine function. And amplitude A equals this one, and omega equals this one. This A omega R, very small, means the CR perturbation is small. And then we will get an N horseshoe with topological entropy. We choose K in such a way. A times this one almost larger than one. And this is almost less than A. The meaning is this. The meaning is this. Why we take the two conditions? The two conditions ensure that we have this picture. That means this cosine function is not very high, not very low. It has intersection with I in this way. And also the amplitude is suitable. And also this K ensures ensure the following. We can, for each n, choose n large enough so that the topological entropy of the n Hausdorff is greater than this number. From variational principle, there exists an ergodic measure such that the measure theoretical entropy is larger than this one. Well, since this map expands unstable direction about n times and contract the stable direction about one over n times. So the Lyapunov exponents will close to this number, which almost equal to this one. Moreover, since by iteration of D, the delta spends most of time near P. So mu n is close to the periodic measure, delta P. And let n large if necessary, such that this is true. This means what measure we choose is close to mu P. And the Lyapunov exponents of this measure larger than this. Now we denote lambda, we denote this one. Okay, to conclude, for any diffeo G from a open set nu, which is a subset of mu, and the continuation of G, by small perturbation, we can get a diffeo Gn satisfies the following property we named Sn. The first property is there exists a hyperbolic basic set and an ergodic measure on that, such that the entropy is larger than it. The second is the measure very close to mu p, and the Lyapunov exponent is larger than this. Then we denote mu n as the subset of nu satisfies the property Sn, and denote this subset. This mu n is clearly an open property. And from the above discussion, it is density. So R is a generic set. Now, for G from the residual set R and the continuation P, there exists a sequence of ergodic measures, nu n, such that nu n close to approach nu p, and the Lyapunov exponents greater than this. So from definition, this means nu n and nu p and mu p are supported on the same passing set with these three parameters. But in this case, we see the entropy is positive. But of course, the entropy of mu p is zero. So in this case, we find a counterexample of upper semi-continuous. Well, let's say more. Note that although for each n, mu n is supported on a uniformly hyperbolic basic set. And the angle between ES and EU in this basic set is uniformly bounded by about this quantity. But if you ask n goes to infinity, n goes to infinity, then this angle between the stable and the unstable bundle could go to zero. So in this case, the two bundles have no domination. So from this example, we see maybe we need a domination to prove the upper semi-continuity. Now, this is the definition of domination. And then we proved the following theorem. Let F be a C1 diffeo of a compact Riemannian manifold. And let lambda be a Poisson set with a domination splitting. Then the entropy map is upper semi-continuous. Okay, upper semi-continuous continuity of entropy map holds for C1 plus domination, but not for C1 plus alpha. Goes a little against a common intuition that conclusions are usually parallel between C1 plus domination and C1 plus alpha. We mention two examples. One example is stable manifold theorem, which is proved by Abadio, Bonatti, Croatia, and also Poisson formula, proved by Tian and me. Okay. Let's make some remarks. The dominator splitting can be extended to its closure, but the closure lambda bar may support non-hyperbolic measures. An application of theorem in three-dimensional case is a class of C1 robustly transitive partially hyperbolic diffeos on T3 introduced by Manet, where the Lyapunov components of center bundle is not zero. For high dimensional case, Bonatti and Vienna constructed a C1 open set of diffeo with dominant splitting, but in this case, they admire non-hyperbolic bundles, where the closure is supported, where the closure is the whole T2, T4, and which supported an SRP measure by Ali. Well, the topological pressure, we can take this one as a definition. The upper semi-continuity implies there exists equilibrium state. The meaning is this. Provided there exists a sequence in the closed subset of this set such that this limit, equality is true. And this condition is satisfied by many systems with some hyperbolic from hyperbolicity, including Manet's example and Bonatti's Vienna's example, where in their examples, the closure of a certain open neighborhood of the unique maximal entropy measure is contained in this subset by liang, liao, and tian. Of course, people know much about these two examples. For example, the entropy, the Boozy's work, and many others' work. Okay. Well, now we talk about the proof of the theorem. This is the definition of entropy. And then, let's say, we fix one measure and a real and one partition. And then, this part is smaller than zero by definition. And this part is continuous because the border has no measure. And thus, this is upper semi-continuous at mu. So this is less than smaller number. So let's say, to show the upper semi-continuous, we should estimate the difference of this. But the difference less than tau plus zero plus this difference. So to show the upper semi-continuity at mu, we need to show that this difference is small for a partition for all the measures in this subset. This is the key point we need to show. To do so, we use the local entropy. Local entropy, we know Bowen's work, Newhouse, and someone else. Okay, our definition is a little bit different from that work, a little bit different. So one way is we define it pointwise. We define two such entropy. One is with star, one is not with star. Okay. Of course, this one is smaller than this. Well, position. By using our definition, then the difference between one entropy and the entropy with a partition will controlled from upper side by this interval. This help us much because in this case, in this case, the hyperbolicity assumption of measures guarantee some kind of uniform hyperbolicity for a set with a large measure for all nearby measures. So from this, we say this one could be in a large measure could be small, and the small measure part we can control it. So then applying domination and police lemma, we can get a small local entropy, and from this one we can get our conclusion. Well, we denote we denote the ball. This is a centered mu, and the diameter is rho. And then we talk some detail. Because we consider the passing site, the measures supported on the passing site with some hyperbolic property. So this means nearby measures, nearby measures, have this hyperbolicity property in a large set. The assumption of domination admits fake foliation by Bruins and Wenxiang on the passing set. The fake foliation has two properties. One is almost tangency. Another is local invariants. And this number, R0, is unified. So by using this local invariant fake foliations with uniform size, we can construct a local product structure. This local product structure, together with hyperbolic time police lemma, yields the following. This one is the Bowen ball centered at x and with radius r with the infinite length. Well, this claim says for fixed one measure mu and sigma, there exists r rho and measure set with big measure. With big measure, for any measure, for many measure, this T is uniform for all the measures, for all the measures. In this case, if you take the center at T at this subset with big measure, then the Bowen ball contains exactly the center itself. So, of course, the entropy with star is zero. But what we use is not the star. What we use is a little bit bigger than this star. So, from this claim together with some estimation, one can prove that this one is bigger than the entropy star with star, but this one still less, still small. So let's say the you say in the big subset with subset with big measure, the difference is small, and in the complement which is with a small measure, the local entropy is bounded. So from this we say the difference is small for all the measures nearby P and any partition psi. And so the difference is small, and this proved our theorem. Thanks.